Greetings, I'm Mr. Spiffy, and welcome to the bottom of the barrel. I know, 2 weeks in a row, I'm doing the whole webcam thing. And this week, I'm doing it because, frankly, I'm piss tired, and I just don't feel like setting up my tripod and the camera and going through the editing process and everything else, because I got woken up really fucking early, at least early for me today. At about 8 o'clock this morning. And for some of you, you're probably going, 8's not that early, but I work nights. And right now, I'll let you in on a little something that's going on with me. I'm currently filing for bankruptcy. And invariably, when you're going through these kind of bullshit with creditors are going to call you. And while most of my creditors seem to get it through their skull that, hey, I'm going through bankruptcy, I need to contact his lawyer. No, this one creditor keeps assuming it's perfectly all right to keep calling me and asking me about shit that's going on instead of contacting my lawyer. Really freaking annoying. At least I'll let them know, hey, I'm a day sleeper, don't fucking wake me up. And so hopefully that'll be made perfectly clear. I'd like to talk a little bit about Monday Night Raw and Main Event. Mostly just because, well, Main Events happen, and Main Event seems to be becoming a bit of a thing now where, where it's actually being important because it's live on the network and, you know, there's more to it. So I'm going to kind of be flitting back and forth between it because I'm going to be talking about the different wrestlers and different things that are going on. Like to talk about the start of the show, stuff that happened with Shield and Evolution. Of course, we started the show with the Shield and Evolution, we ended the show with Shield and Evolution. And that was the show meaning Raw. And we started off with the Shield basically saying, you know, hey, Evolution, what you did to us, yeah, you laid us out, but is that all you got? You got nothing else. And we want Evolution again at Payback, and we're going to hunt down Evolution tonight. And sure enough, as soon as Evolution arrived, the Shield went back. We got a backstage brawl. Evolution basically going and getting their asses handed to them by the Shield. Shield getting dragged away. Later on, Evolution comes out in the middle of the show, says they accept the challenge, whatnot. Shield again jumps Evolution, chases them off. Batista gets all piss poor and basically goes, yo, Roman Reigns, you're the big dog. I'm sick of it. 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 Because he's a broken record, much like Paul Heyman, and goes off and, you know, challenges Roman Reigns to a one-on-one match. A one-on-one match that, of course, ends in a double disqualification for both sides because, you know, it broke down into another brawl. Solid brawling, solid everything going there. Can't really complain. You had the whole incident is going on with Damian Sandow, which went over the Raw pre-show. Then Raw itself and Main Event, where Sandow is feeling very disgruntled and feeling like that the company is not going to give him any airtime and that they're just going to keep having him job out and that, you know, this is the only opportunity he's going to get. And obviously this is a work or a worked shoot. I can't say, you know, where it's coming from, but it's an opportunity for Sandow to change and an opportunity for Sandow to get something more going for him. Unfortunately, he's still on the losing end of things, but you know, they're cutting off his microphone, and he's having to talk into Josh Matthews' microphone on the pre-show. He still hasn't said anything truly poignant outside. He was saying, they've handcuffed me, and he came out during Raw before his matchup with Cody Rhodes, and had the had a microphone hidden on him, and tried to get more opportunities to talk. You know, not much came out of that. And again, on Main Event, he snags Tony Chimmel's microphone. Doesn't get to say much before they interrupt him with Dolph Ziggler. In both cases, good matches against Ziggler and good matches against Cody Rhodes. Rhodes cheating to win to try to get himself because Cody has been on a losing streak. So we're getting that little bit of Cody about ready to turn heel again with raking the eyes on Damian Sandow and then hitting the disaster kick. So we're seeing a lot of development there. I'm really hoping that, you know, this whole disgruntled employee thing works out for Damian Sandow and that they actually give him the push he deserves and actually gets him back in a position where he gets on with his winning ways, because I like Damian Sandow. I think he's a good character. I think he's a decent wrestler, and I think he deserves the opportunity. Speaking of disgruntled wrestlers, we'll move on to Miss Alicia Fox, who beat up Paige and attacked her before the matchup and insulted her, and then lost her match just after one maneuver. Again, on main, and then threw a huge frickin' hissy fit, tore apart the announce table, getting all up in everyone's faces, walking out with JBL's hat. You then have a similar situation on main event where she attacks Emma, then, beating down Emma through most of the matchup, and then Emma gets in a schoolboy roll-up, 1, 2, 3. Emma gets out of there before taking a further beating, but. And then afterwards, she attacks, Tony Chimmel, attacks some random grip guy at ringside, producer, whatever, attacks Tom Phillips, the commentator, shoves a script into his mouth, is demanding both her that both Byron Saxton and her give him all their money. So she's a mugger now? I don't know. She does the $1 million man thing, but like shoving the script into both their mouths, and it's pretty a sad thing, the fact that Byron Saxton is a former in-ring competitor, and he pretty much had to be kowtowed by freaking Alicia Fox, and Alicia going, "Who's underrated now? Who's underrated?" Alicia, let me put this to you. No one has ever said you were underrated. We said you just plain sucked. You were undisciplined and dangerous in the ring. Your axe kick looks like it'll take someone's head off. You look like you are very green in the ring. Now, you have improved. I do see a marketable improvement in you. Now, whether or not this leads to a push, I can't say, but she's bitch-festing! Let's see, we've got. We've got the whole situation with Daniel Bryan and Kane, which has now come to a more or less a conclusion because tomorrow Daniel Bryan has to go in for surgery on his neck. Now, from what I understand, it's not serious surgery, it's minor neck surgery. He does apparently have a cracked vertebrae, but they're going to kind of analyze his time frame after the surgery based on what they find, because it's very possible that when you go in for neck surgery, it could be a lot worse than it actually appears at first, or vice versa. So my hope is that Daniel Bryan makes it through okay, and then he will be back in the ring, and that this won't turn out like Edge, where his career is severely shortened. As far as I know, he's not getting a neck fusion like Edge or Kurt Angle had. It's going to be something completely different. Hopefully, it'll work out. And this isn't just due to Kane and his tombstones. This is years upon years of work on him and doing the Chris Benoit headbutts and things of that sort. It's really taken its toll on his body, and 10 years plus in the business can do that to you, going nonstop around the world, not really stopping for much. I mean, like you said, he's had his orbital bone cracked. He has trouble seeing out of one of his eyes because of that. There's he's had a detached retina. I think that's what Daniel had said previously. The fact is, he's come back from other stuff. He can come back from this. I believe it to be possible. I'm not sure exactly, what they're going to do with the WWE Championship, and I think that's the reason why they're waiting until Raw to make the announcement of what they're going to do, because they want to see what the results. Oh, hey, sorry. Sorry to be yawning at you there. They want to see the results of his surgery, and because if it's only going to be like, oh, minor surgery, he's only out for a few weeks, they'll keep the championship on him, something like that. They may determine, it's not likely that they're going to let him keep the belt, unfortunately, but there's two possibilities with stripping him. One, they strip him, they hold a battle royal or a tournament or something to determine the new WWE World Heavyweight Champion, and someone's going to win it. More than likely, it'll happen between now and Payback or between now and Money in the Bank. I doubt it'll extend all the way out to SummerSlam. That's a long time to be without a world heavyweight champion. There's a possibility, of course, that Daniel will keep the belt, and then he'll just keep it in limbo until such time as they reach, you know, he's able to come back. The third option is that they could strip him of the WWE World Heavyweight Championship and give it to Kane. Because Kane was the one who took him out, and Kane was the top contender, so Kane gets the title. And, you know, that's a very reasonable storyline possibility. But with Kane supposedly leaving after Payback, at least that was the original plan, the only way to really write Kane out is that Kane will have to probably successfully defend the WWE World Heavyweight Championship at Payback, and then at Money in the Bank, have a matchup, successfully defend the title, but be very nearly beaten down, and then get the Money in the Bank cashed in on him and lose the title. Though that's a reasonable possibility. I'm not sure where else they're going to go with it. I feel bad for Daniel because, you know, he's worked really hard, and hopefully this will not kill his fan push. The fans still seem to be behind him, and that's a good thing. Although, on Monday, he did have about a 50-50 where some fans, I think the fans knew that about his neck injury, and they were going, no, no, no. Not because they didn't want him there, but because they didn't want to hear from him a confirmation of the injury. And I had to laugh about him saying, wow, now I know what John Cena feels like. Speaking of Cena, Cena and the Usos took on the Wyatts. Cena and the Usos picked up the victory, unlike on Friday from SmackDown. Cena has now been challenged by Bray Wyatt, and apparently it has been confirmed, at least through WWE.com. Bray Wyatt versus John Cena, last man standing match at Payback. We also have Evolution versus The Shield, also at Payback. And then there's Sheamus. And I want to talk about the fact that Sheamus has actually had a pretty stellar week so far. He had two great back-to-back matches, with both decent matches with Curtis Axel and Ryback. Both were very enjoyable. He had a match which ended in a double count-up. It was a great brawl with him and Cesaro. And I'm looking forward to more matches between him and Cesaro. I really would like to see them compete and battle over the U.S. Championship. And I think Sheamus, you know, for supposedly turning heel when he bro-kicked Ambrose had won the U.S. belt. That was his big heel turn. No, apparently not. They've just kind of flopped that one. They're like, we'll save that for another day. Toss it over his shoulder. And so Sheamus isn't a heel. Sheamus is still the same guy he always was. And he is the U.S. champion. More power to him. And then, of course, we've got another build towards Payback, which is Adam Rose getting involved with Jack Swagger's matchup on Raw, and basically allowing RVD to get a completely quick victory over Jack Swagger. And Rose and RVD go off to party together. RVD will bring the weed, and Adam Rose brings the gay? I don't know. I'm not sure where they're going with this, but obviously it's going to be another one of those. Jack Swagger trying to stop an evil foreigner, and losing. This is Jack Swagger's career now. I can't see anybody really benefiting from joining the Real Americans, but eventually they'll have somebody do so. And I don't recall Bad News Barrett making an appearance on Raw. So, yeah. Oh, yeah! And Big E continues the downward spiral, speaking of Bad News Barrett, when he decided to go help Hacksaw Jim Duggan, who was going to get his ass beat by Rusev. And Rusev, now with only one name, because Alexander is apparently just too hard to say or remember. Big E comes in for the help. So much for his push as being a powerhouse. He takes a big frickin' kick to the head. And that was it for him. But at least Hacksaw didn't get beat up. So I guess it served its purpose. All in all, we're looking for potentially Big E taking on Rusev, probably with Hacksaw Jim Duggan in his corner. I expect to probably see that at Payback. We're seeing Alicia Fox probably being put in line to be number one contender for the Divas Championship, despite the fact that she's lost two matches in a row. She's just going on a huge bitch fest. We had an unimportant Divas match that had only to do with Total Divas, and no fucks were given. Overall, Raw was pretty good. Main event was enjoyable. I think they've got a decent build start for Payback. We have two matches announced, which is nice because there's still 3 weeks till the pay-per-view. So it's good to see that they actually have somewhat of a plan in mind. Usually when we come to the June pay-per-view, not so much, and it usually gets rushed. Although they did Extreme Rules a little bit earlier in the month of May, so it gave more time for the build-up for Payback, and I think that's a good thing. Alright, that about covers it. Later this week, I'll be back with Mania Week, doing a rather unique concept, something that was suggested to me by one of my viewers, one that I hadn't ever touched on. I decided I was going to go ahead and do this as part of my Mania Week follow-up, and this will probably be my last Mania Week follow-up. Doesn't mean I won't talk about WrestleMania in the future, because obviously there's more WrestleMania stuff to talk about. But what I'm going to be looking at, side-by-side, the top five best and top five worst celebrity appearances at WrestleMania, based, of course, on my opinion. Feel free to give me your comments below in regard to Raw and Main Event. I'm sure I probably missed something, but, you know, I'm too tired. I'm kind of all over the place, but feel free to give me your comments. Let me know what you think. If you liked the show, you didn't like the show. As always, please like, share, subscribe. I've gotten some new subscribers again. Thank you so much for everyone who's continuing to subscribe to me. I appreciate it very much. I'm Mr. Spiffy, and this barrel's been scraped clean. I might take a nap before work. Catch you guys later.